This is a CBC podcast.
Now, residents of Belle Island will soon be counted among the many people in this province who are struggling to find a family doctor. Last month, we learned two of the three practicing GPs on the island would be ending their practice. And now, the one remaining doctor has announced that they will be leaving in December. For more on the impact of this news, we're joined by Kara O'Keefe, a pharmacist on Belle Island. Good morning, Kara.
Good morning.
So we spoke to you last month after two doctors announced their departure. How did you find out about this latest news, and how are you feeling about it?
So I found out about this from our mayor yesterday, Gary Design, who announced that Eastern Health had confirmed that our last physician is going to be leaving Belle Island at the end of December. So myself and most residents and our patients here at the pharmacy are feeling very alarmed and very overwhelmed right now because as of right now, we don't have a replacement physician.
You tweeted about this last night, noting that, you know, Belle Island has, quote, a community hospital with a family practice, a long-term care site, addiction center, and an emergency room. How is the loss of these doctors going to impact those services?
So, simply put, you cannot have those services without a physician. So physicians are integral quarterbacks of the healthcare system, and without having them present in our community, then a lot of those services simply won't be viable. So unless our government and Eastern Health can help find a physician, then we simply won't be able to deliver those services to patients in our community.
When you spoke to the mayor yesterday, had he gotten any word from Eastern Health about the plans going forward?
No. As of right now, there is an application process that's available for physicians who are looking to apply for the position. And to the best of my knowledge, we still have no candidates who've come forward.
What have you been hearing from people at your pharmacy and community members about how concerned they are about access to healthcare in the province and on Belle Island?
They're very concerned. And I would say especially our elderly patients. So Belle Island has a lot of aging population. So a lot of our patients are over the age of 65. We have high rates of chronic disease burden. So we have large rates of diabetes, congestive heart failure, COPD, which is a disease of the lungs, high blood pressure, high cholesterol. So a lot of them are coming to me and asking, well, who's going to help manage my diabetes now? Who's going to be prescribing my diabetes medicine? Who's going to check my blood pressure for me? Who is going to check in on my testing when I have to go get my MRI? So they're very concerned because they don't know who's going to be here to help provide them with the health care that they need.
How is your work, specifically your scope of responsibilities and how you serve your clients, how is that going to be impacted throughout this?
So I think in times of need, when we need healthcare, patients do tend to turn to their pharmacy and to their pharmacist more. We saw that more during COVID-19 when some family physicians weren't able to serve patients from their own practice and had to serve them at home. You had a lot of patients coming to their pharmacist for assessment on things where they normally go to see their family physician or to an emergency room when those things weren't available. So I think pharmacists are very much willing and looking forward to stepping up where we can. We don't serve as a replacement for a physician, and we do know when it is appropriate to refer someone, but there is a lot of times when a pharmacist can be doing more. So in other provinces like Alberta, for example, we see pharmacists prescribing for uncomplicated urinary tract infections. They also take a more active role in helping patients to manage their diabetes, their high blood pressure, their high cholesterol. So allowing pharmacists to expand their scope can also offset some of the burden that we have on our healthcare system right now. So that if it takes longer, for example, for someone to get in to see a physician, that we can help bridge some of those gaps and help improve outcomes in the healthcare system.
You know, we've heard about this before, you know, increasing that capacity for pharmacists in the province. Do you have any sense of where that conversation is right now with the province and pharmacists?
So that's a great question. Luckily, I've actually been elected onto Pharmacists Association Board of Directors as of this week. So I'll probably be able to speak a little bit more to that in the coming months when I'm taking a more active role in that. But as of right now, I know that the Pharmacists Association has been making presentations on behalf of pharmacists across the province to the Health Accord, and basically showing what evidence that we have for allowing pharmacists to practice in this way and showing how we can improve health outcomes and actually save the province millions of dollars.
What would you like to see the government do to address the situation on Belle Island right now?
Right now, we are we are in a crisis. So it, in my opinion, it's gone past the point of sitting down and consulting with people and having boardroom meetings. Like, we need a physician now. So there needs to be an urgent call put out. So this is an Eastern Health problem. This is a government problem. This is something that needs to be dealt with immediately. So whether that means providing someone with a house to come live in when they're on Belle Island, because right now the ferry service is unreliable, or giving someone a bonus to come to rural Newfoundland. Something like that needs to be done, because by December, our community is going to be in crisis.
Kara, I want to thank you for your time this morning.
Thank you very much for having me.
For more CBC podcasts, go to cbc.ca/podcasts.